topic we have, that is surges. So what is the surge? Let's see that. When the flow in the channel is suddenly decreases or increases by closing or opening a sluice gate. Sluice gate is a kind of opening provided in the way of hydraulic flow. Okay, we can just open, or just like a tap, you just open or close, so we can just control the flow of water. Okay, so opening a sluice gate, there is a sudden change in water level. Okay, how the change in the water level? If you close the gate, so the coming water will be restored before the gate, so there will be change in the there will be rise in the water level. Okay, and as we open the sluice gate, so what will happen, that stored water will be released next to of the gateway. Okay, and the level of water will be decreased. Okay, will be reduced. Okay, similarly we see, and this change occurs in both at the upstream and downstream of the gate. Okay, this phenomena is called surge. So simple simple case. Okay, so when you close the gate, so water will be restored at the before the gate, and as you open, so that stored water will be released, and there will be sudden loss in the head of the water. Okay, so this is the surge. Okay, next one, there are a few types of surges. Let's see that there are two types of surges. So first one is, has surge can be classified into two types. First one is the positive surge, next one is the negative surge. Okay, in the positive surge, we see that in the positive surge, a surge producing increasing in depth. Okay, when there is an increase, so that kind of situation, that is called as positive surge. And when there is a negative surge, it means that the surge producing decrease in the depth, when the depth got decreased. Okay, so that is the negative surge. So simple definition we have. Okay, there are two types. First one is a positive surge, another one is the negative surge. Okay, next we have, by means of this diagram, we will try to understand, okay, what are the phenomena working together. Okay, surge through the channel transition. So there's a channel. Okay, let's see how the things is working together. So here, when the surge arrives at channel transition, it will usually split into two components. Okay, so surges on traveling forward. Okay, so surges with traveling forward, and the other one traveling backward direction of flow. Okay, here you see, there is a kind of flow. Okay, there is a flow direction. Suppose this is a kind of channel. Okay, flow direction is there. Okay, and there is a positive surge through a contraction. Here you see, there are number of things. Okay, that V3 we have. V3 is the velocity of the backward surge. Okay, once the gate is closed, so it will experiencing that velocity backward surge, velocity of backward surge, that is V3. And that S3 is the height of backward reflected surge. Okay, backward reflected surge, why? Because there is some flow of fluid is coming, and once the gate will be closed, so it will be just reflected by that gate, because it is closed, so it will be reflected back, and it will be experiencing that backward reflected surge. Okay, similarly, the velocity also experience a velocity of backward surge will be experienced. Okay, so next we see H1 is the height of incoming surge. So this is the incoming surge which we see. Okay, now we see this is the cross section. Okay, this is the gate of sluice gate. Okay, now we see this is the V1. V1 is the velocity of the incoming surge. Okay, and S2 is the height of fluid surge. Okay, this is the head, actually height of the fluid surge. Okay, stored. Now V2 is the velocity of forward surge. Okay, this is the V2 is the velocity of forward surge. Okay, similarly, this V1 is the velocity of incoming surge, and H1 is the height of the incoming surge. So at the both the side, you will find that H1, S2. Okay, similarly V2, V3. Okay, and S2 and S3. So simple diagram, you can just once you draw and just note it down all the various points. So you will get the idea. Okay, now this is another section you see, showing you the positive surge through a contraction. Okay, and this is the flow direction by this diagram. Okay. Now another figure will showing you some more variation, that is positive surge through an enlargement. When there is a case of enlargement is there, okay, when the things will be allowed to flow. So we will see this kind of cross section you will experience. S2, S3, so all the heads you can see, similar figure it is. Okay. Now this is the flow direction, as you can see. Similarly, at the condition of negative surge to a contraction, then we will find this kind of situation where you see the flow of water is there and there is a head is H1. First, H1 is this much, S2 is this much. Okay, similar kind of diagram. Okay, this condition will show you the negative surge through a contraction. Next, the similar kind of diagram repeated. Okay. Next situation will be like that, negative surge through an enlargement. When we offering, the flow is like this. Okay. So this is the direction of flow. Now, here you see, once the gate will flow, that will be offering some heads and the velocity is like this. This is showing you the direction of flow. Okay. So this was, let's see some more points of about it. So assume that, just figure out some visuals in your mind. Okay. So assume that the water is initially at rest and that energy losses occurs at the transition. Okay. Suppose you store that water. So energy is at, water is at rest. Okay. When you just release the water, so there is a transmit of the that energy. Okay. There's a loss of the loss occurs. Okay. In forms of head, velocity, and various phenomena we had just gone through. Okay. So the water is initially at rest and that energy losses occurs at the transition. When the transition we allow, when we open the sluice gate, so what will happen? We allow the water to flow. And when the water will flow, so there will be loss in form of transitions. Okay. In the form of energies. Okay. Let's see that. What are the things involved in it? So first it says that by continuity of the flow in the rectangular channel. So we are just assuming that the channel is rectangular and when the flow is allowed, so what are the things will be acting together? Let's see that. That will be A1 V1 is equals to A2 V2 plus A3 V3. So these are the three things we had just seen in the this. Okay. We'll be working here. Okay. Now T1 V1 H1 is equals to T2 V2 S2 plus T3 V3 and S3. Okay. Now it will show you conservation of energy principle. What it says? It says that conservation of energy principle. What it means? Whatever the energy is generated, that will be transmitted also. Okay. And it states that the total amount of energy remains same after the split of the incoming surge. Okay. When you allow the surge and you allow the flow, so that will be same. Okay. Now we see energy equation for the surges during a common time interval is given by that is H1 square T1 V1 is equals to S2 square T2 V2 plus S3 square T3 V3. Okay. This is the equation. So there are some cases. Let's see that. At case one, which is the positive surge. We learned about the positive end. At positive surge, so the passing through a contraction. So when we are at the positive surge situation, we have so that V1 is equals to V3 and T1 is equals to T3. So that is at the case one when we are talking about the positive surge. So this is a condition. And so the equation we get, that is T1 V1 H1 is equals to T2 V2 S2 plus T1 V1 S3. Now on solving, further solving, we get that H1 square T1 V1 is equals to S2 square T2 V2 plus S3 square T1 V1. Okay. Now, substituting H1 plus S3. So, by using this equation, H1 plus S3 is equals to S2. Okay, so let's put all the values. So T1 V1 under bracket H1 square minus S3 square is equals to H1 plus S3 square plus T2 V2. Okay, now on solving this equation, we will be solving for S3 and S2. We get the value for, try to guess the value for S3 and S2. So we will have the H1 under bracket T1 V1 minus T2 V2 upon T2 V2 plus T1 V1. Okay. And for S2, we get that H1 under bracket 2 T1 V1 upon T2 V2 plus T1 V1. Okay. So above equation says that the ratio of the height of reflected surge to the height of incoming surge is known as the reflection coefficient, that we denoted by the CR. Okay. So just note that the ratio of the height of reflected surge to the height of the incoming surge is known as the reflection coefficient. Okay, that is CR. Further says, there's one more situation. We can just take that also. So also considered, V1 is almost equals to V2. Okay, so value for CR, we get that under bracket 1 minus n upon under bracket n plus 1. Okay, in the case of, so this was the condition. Now we will talk about the positive reflections. So in the case of positive reflection, CR is equals to 1. A positive surge is reflected as a positive surge and a negative surge is reflected as the negative surge. Now in the case of negative reflection, CR is equals to minus 1. A positive surge is reflected as a negative surge and vice versa. So